All right. What kind of shenanigans are going to happen now? Shit.
Tango Foxtrot, Captain OG. You got your ears on out there, Captain? Over.
Zulu Tango Foxtrot, this is Captain OG. I read you. Over.
Captain, Alpha 6 wants to know when you're going to clear Fort Choppa. He's eager to deploy our first Zed busting squad as the next step in Operation Navis Game. Over.
Copy that, ZTF. Please inform the CO that I've been black on fuel and spending a lot of time siphoning old gas. But I've now figured out how to distill my own fuel in a chemistry station acquired from that old codger. It's a bit of a football bat, but it works. Over.
Roger that, Captain. Say, how are you managing with them 7-day horde attacks? Over.
Well, ZTF, they appear to be escalating each time they occur. I'm going to have to create a seriously hardened site if I'm going to continue surviving those onslaughts. Over.
Acknowledge, Captain. Alpha 6 says that once you bring Fort Choppa online, he'll provide you a fire team to assist. Over.
Tango Mike, ZTF. One more thing. Please inform the CO that I'll be PCS to RLS Charlie at 2410780, as that location is more central, and it'll make a better FOB.
Acknowledge, Captain. I need to sign off and go pull some parts from a hangar queen. My barber pole nearly malfunctioned the other day, and I could have gone tits up.
Roger that, ZTF. Over and out. All right, welcome back, everybody, to 7 Days to Die on Alpha 21. This is the Apocalypse Ranger series, and I am an old guy gaming. And we have a sleeper left over from last night's little zombie raid that we had there that I showed at the very beginning of the video. So let's take care of her, and then we have... I got a couple things I need to talk to you guys about what's going to happen next. So let's get rid of the sleepy first. I'm going to turn my light off. In fact, it's so dang dark out. Why don't we put these on so we can use our night vision? And let's also send her a 7.62 right to her cranium. Just got to figure out where she's at. I think she's right around over on the wall over there. So, yeah, I was mining last night and... had attracted quite the horde, you know, with a couple screamer screams too. And at some point I probably should think about maybe upgrading this base, except for that we're probably not going to be here too much longer, which is part of what I wanted to talk to you guys about. So let's put our nerdies back on. So first of all, I believe I said in the last episode that we were going to go, we were going to go do a tier 5 today, but I've changed my mind. We're going to postpone that. Mostly because we are approaching Horde Night. It's tomorrow, and I don't have a new solution in place, and I don't want to continue using our current base. So what my plan is... I mean, I've told you guys a couple of times now, I have a plan for an ultimate base, and I'm excited to do it. I think it's going to be fun and effective and all that, but... it's going to take some doing, so we're not going to be ready, definitely not have that base ready by tomorrow. So I have a kind of a temporary base plan in mind that I'm going to spend all day tomorrow, in-game day tomorrow, putting together. It should be fairly simplistic, but hopefully still effective. So what we're going to do in this episode is we're going to go ahead and clear Fort Choppa to continue our role-playing progression here with Captain OG and Alpha 6 and Sulu Tango Foxtrot. Because I want, you know, I want to keep interspersing that roleplay with this series as we go along. And then what I'm planning to do is, why is that different than that? I don't know. What I'm planning to do is, and this was actually a suggestion by one of you guys in the comments, is I'm gonna try and incorporate the NPC mod, the 7 Days to Die NPC mod, into our series, and basically have a fire team of three additional NPC soldiers that will then accompany OG as he continues his adventures. And I think that should be a lot of fun. I did a little bit of testing on a backup save, and it seems to work. Now they do say in the mod, they recommend not. Oh, wait a minute. That's not even supposed to be there. Oh, well, whatever. I don't care. They do recommend in the mod that that you should start a new game. But I'm gonna chance it, and hopefully it doesn't break anything really bad. If it does break anything really bad, then what my plan is to start a Season 2 series where we will continue more or less where we left off, within the limits of, you know, starting a new save and go from there. And I have some other plans to enhance that with some more mods too. But if the NPC mod does not break anything major, we'll just continue with this series for, you know, as long as I feel like we need to continue with it. Okay, anyway, I think that kind of brings you up to date on all of those plans. So today we're going to go ahead and take out Fort Choppa, and we're going to do Fort Choppa B as opposed to the first Fort Choppa that we found that's way over here. And I wanted to, that drop's not there anymore. I want to move to this central area here too. I suppose we could move to this Fort Choppa, but it's still a decent ways away from the central area of the map. In fact, Trader Jin? Yeah, Trader Jin is almost exactly in the center of the map, but I'm not really looking to live in the desert. So I was thinking about more down here by Trader Bob. And this area is also, you know, pretty flat too. And I believe, if I remember from our previous first few episodes before I restarted the series, is that I think there's a ranger station up here, and I think it's a Charlie ranger station that we could take over, and that can become our new forward operating base. The other bad thing about this Fort Choppa too is that it doesn't have a direct access to this highway. You can get there going around this way, but that might be a good reason for me to go back to my original plan where I was going to kind of cut a highway through here. You know, the advantage of doing something like that is we get a ton of XP and a ton of materials, but it would take a long time. So I don't know. There's lots of options. We'll just kind of see how things play out. Anyway, let's get started with today's episode. So we are going to head over to Fort Choppa and get that taken care of. So I'll meet you guys over there. All right, we are here, and this is a tier... What is this? This is a tier 4. Okay. So we are definitely... should be capable of handling a tier 4, plus the fact that it's not an infested. So I'm not saying it's going to be a walk in the park, but I'm saying we should, you know, be able to handle it. All right, so let me look in here really quick. I think I'm going to... Let's bring the sledge turret with us just in case we might need it for something. Oh, I made some cooking pot mines too, so we may make use of those. And I think we'll keep everything else with us. Oh, at the moment, somebody just blew themselves up. All right, so this is not an actual quest that we're doing. It's just a random loot, so we don't have to worry about... Oh, that must have been an animal that did that. So we don't have to worry about, you know, completing the quest, that sort of thing. It looks like it wants us to come in through here. Okay, so let's get this party started. Go in nice and quiet to the... Looks like this might be the command center because it's got all of the, servers. What the hell? Forget about the guy behind us. Let's deal with him first. Is that cloth really that tough? Okay. Dispatched. Oh, in here? What about in here? Okay, so looks like that clears this first room. That is not lootable. Is this lootable? Yes, it is. Let's check it out and see what's in there. Some cornmeal. All right, we'll take that. Cornmeal is very useful. Even though it's a bit ubiquitous in the loot, but still very useful nonetheless. It's actually a good thing that it's ubiquitous because then I don't have to waste resources making it. There we go. Gumbo stew. That's it. We have completely maxed out food. 100 of 100. Very nice. Okay. And keep in mind, you know, I only put 1 point into Master Chef to achieve that. So the fun pimps are pretty generous with that one. I hope they continue to be too, because it just this makes the game a little more enjoyable. Okay, we've got a doghouse there. Incidentally, I'm not familiar with this PO. I don't think I've ever done it. It might even be new to 21 because I don't remember ever seeing it before. Okay, let's go up here. Is this one of those deals where they don't spawn in until my feet touch the ground? Okay, so moving forward... We either sell these for 22, we scrap them for 3 paper, which isn't worth it, or I think if we consume them, we get a little bit of XP. The next one we come across, we'll see. I was going to try and stop that before it scrapped, but it scrapped so quickly that I didn't get to it. All right, let's jump down to here. Guess we move over here next. Oh, look at that. Damn buzzard. Get out of here. That guy, I think, is on the outside, so hopefully he'll dispatch himself with a landmine. Okay, let's move this way. Check the army truck. I'm no longer going to loot gas now that we can make it, because we don't need to. All right, we're going to take this, we're going to eat this, and we're going to scrap those. That you were supposed to die on the landmines. Damn it. Scrap that chair. I'll hang onto the paper for the moment in case we come across one of those big pallets of paper. I don't think that's lootable. Nope. Okay, let's go over here. That's where the damn dog was hiding out. Nothing in here? No loot items anyway. Hmm. Oh, we got this. I'll take that and that. Okay, we'll move into this section. Trigger. How many are we talking about? Quite a few. Okay. How the hell is this not open? Or loaded? Wait, this is me we're talking about. What the fuck? I just loaded it. I must not have let it finish. Okay. That was pretty bad. I just felt like using a knife. Jeez. Oh, man. There's just no way that I can only speak for myself. There's just no way that I can always remember to always load the weapons. I mean, I could do better. I can certainly do better, though. But it's just so easy to forget in this game. Ooh, nice. Okay, and we got a big hitters, too. Let's get rid of that. Okay. Now, let's make sure all of our weapons are fully loaded. Yep, see? It's because I was messing around with mods and stuff, and that's one thing that'll get you often in this game, is if you, let's actually put that on the toolbar. You know, if you forget to reload after you check the mods, so. This is like a little food station mess wagon. Mortician's roar. What the hell, we'll eat it. We got plenty of beverage here. I'm just taking normal water. I guess we'll take the plastic. Let's help out our friend here. Nurse Nancy, knock it off. Okay. You know, I'm starting to think now that I'm looking at Fort Choppa a little more closely, there are much sturdier forts, like Fort Gull, for example, than this place, for Alpha 6 to come in with his Zeke busting squad or whatever it is that CTF called him. So we may change our story and not have them come into to Fort Choppa, and we can find a better fort for that. So. Anyway, I need to pay attention. We're still doing battle here. I mean, it looks like it was a pretty decent place at one point, but it's, you know, there's less, oh shit. You know, like concrete buildings and things like that, and it's more open. I don't know. Let's finish it first, and then I'll make that decision when the time comes. Well, we're kind of messed up, aren't we? Okay. We need to run back to the bike and take a few meds here. And also, I'm going to I'm going to just bust this door open. Oops. I have a bad habit of clicking the fire button twice to reload. You know, it works fine for weapons that have a single shot, like the bow or the crossbow and the hunting rifle, that sort of thing. But then when I get to a semi-automatic weapon, I do that and I waste a round, and I really shouldn't be doing that. All right, I don't want that. Let's just drop off some of this stuff that we looted while we're here. We'll probably be getting more of that. Chicken soup, we'll just eat. Okay, so what do we need? We need to take a cast. We need to take a pill for the concussion and a honey for the infection. Okay, we're almost back to full capacity here. Let's proceed. Another outside Zeke, probably. Okay, take care of him. Okay, let's go into the medical trailer here. Gonna be some Zeke's in those closets, most likely. I'll take that. I'll take all of that. Do we have cloth? Nope. When we get some, though, we'll turn that into a bandage. Ooh. Gotta pay attention to these books. Okay, so this is worth keeping to sell. 110 coin. We won't consume that or scrap it. None of those cupboards. Okay, we got a janitor zombo over there. Can't really get to his head very well, though. Get the pill rack. There we go. Recipes, first aid bandage. Another one. Oh, I guess that's Nurse Nancy. I was thinking that was a janitor, because they both have a blue coverall setup. We use this on not that. Oh shit. I don't have my wrench or thingy on me. I think it's in the bike. That's okay. But if you use a wrench on those IVs, you have a better chance of getting a blood bag from it. Alright, anything out this way? Oh, popping pills. Yeah, what the hell, we'll grab the gas. Why not? Nice. How far away are we from large medikits, medical? We need... Oh, we're 1 point. Awesome. Okay, 1 point away, and then we can make the big first aid kits. I knew we were getting close. Here's a munitions box. You the only one in here? Nope, he's not. Get this ready. Oh shit. clears this room. Corn seed. I don't know if that button's gonna do something more than just open that door. Sometimes when you press them, it's a trigger. Let's put these on. Let's see what's in here. Okay, decent little amount of ammunition. So I guess that's all that did is just open that up. I'm looking to see if there's anything more I may have missed. Oh, I bet you had opened that gate up too. You're still not dead? Take both of those things. And is that? Nope. I was going to say. If that was maybe a plug or something with a secret. Let's jump up here. Anything on the roofs that we may have missed? Not that I can tell. Looks like we get into that container from over here. All right, what kind of shenanigans are going to happen now? Shit. Woo-hoo. Time to go. Need to do is cook it. There we go. Nice. Okay, that was a bit intense. Jeez. Hey, there's stuff over here. Is this lootable? Nope. Let's just open this up. Never mind. Is there a switch that opens that? I don't know. So yeah, that's a good example in this game of where stuff is triggered and it doesn't matter how stealthy you are, it's just gonna happen. Wait. Put these on. There's usually some pretty good stuff in these places. All right, knife guy and machine gunner to sell. That wasn't real good, but whatever. Some ammunition. We'll take the pipes. And those are not lootable, unfortunately. Okay, let's go up here. Nothing. Oh. I don't know what that just did. Oh. It opened that, didn't it? Okay. Maybe Fort Chop is a little more substantial than I was given it credit for. I'm just going to keep my luckies on. This we're going to scrap. Get those medical supplies here. Military goods. Got a shoddy Messiah here. And we're going to have to go drop some stuff off in the bike, too. Explosives. Already checked that. Okay, let's check these buildings here, and then we'll go drop off at the bike and then go down below. All right, let's ditch the paper. That might be where we come out at. I'll have to come back and grab that stuff. Man. Tough. M-O. M-O? M-F. I don't know what I said, why I said that. Ooh, there's a radio. We can tell Zula Tango Foxtrot that we've secured Fort Choppa. But possibly don't recommend it for the FOB. We'll go down below first and before we make that determination. Is this just a single room down here? Or is this tie in with the whole rest of... Oh, wow. It goes back outside that way. Well, that's convenient. Okay, here. Let's just go drop off. I really like this POI though. It's pretty cool. Okay, let's see what we got in here. You've unlocked medical tier recog. Oh, I misread that, didn't I? Shoot. Yeah, we don't hit that till 50, but we only need 10 more, and those magazines are abundant, so I don't anticipate. Oh. This is the main loot? Oh, okay. Then I wonder what that bunker is that goes down at the bottom there. Look at that. We're not really that hungry. Let's eat it. Save a spot. And we got a black strap for mining. Nice stuff. Okay, well, let's open the fat loots, and then we'll still go check that place underneath the heliopad, too, though. I assumed that's where the fat loots would be, but obviously that's not the case, so. That might just be like a single room down below. That is not better than what we have. We'll read that. 10% more sneak damage at night. Ooh, and we finished Night Stalker, guys. All right, what does that give us? I think it gives us an improved lockpicking situation. Night Stalker. Oh, no. Sneak attacks with knives at night deal 200% extra damage. Okay. Well, this is still a very good tree. One of the better ones in the game, in fact. And makes nighttime actions better, of course. Got our military goods there. And we'll scrap those. That's it for up there. Those are not worth doing anything with. Alright, let's check the gun safe next. Laser sight and a magazine extender. Beautiful. Alright. We will once again have to come back for that stuff. But let's go see what's going on down here. Since this isn't a mission, that doesn't mean we haven't cleared all the zombies. Not that we have to clear all the zombies. Oh, that's it, huh? Ooh, though, look at that. Weapons bag. Okay, assault rifles and this. I'm going to... Well, what the hell, we can come back. Alright, guys. So, what I'm going to do is... go... Alright, yeah, we don't have a turn-in. I keep thinking this is an actual job that we've been doing. So I think I'm going to go ahead and wrap up the episode here, and I'm going to spend the rest of today and probably overnight just mining, because I need a crap ton of steel, a crap ton of concrete, all the stuff that we need to prepare for the Horde Night. And I might bring you back before the Horde Night for another episode, or I might bring you back when the Horde Night starts. It just kind of depends upon how things go and how the timing goes of everything. So with that being said, thank you very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. And if you did, please hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. Leave a comment to share the video. And we'll catch you all in the next episode. Bye-bye.